As of April 16, 2023, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is the famous Mount Stromboli volcano in Italy, which is nicknamed the Lighthouse of the Mediterranean, as it has been almost continuously erupting, albeit around 99% of the time, since record-keeping began in the region more than 2,500 years ago. Although it has produced some larger explosions, Stromboli has largely consisted of intermittent Strombolian-type eruptions, with this eruption type being named after this volcano, generally occurring about once every 15 to 30 minutes. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, it was finally confirmed that the Aniakchak volcano, which is currently at a raised alert level of yellow, has an active intrusion of magma at a mere depth of 2 to 2.5 miles below sea level. Also, in Alaska, ash was seemingly emitted in the vicinity of the Mount Katmai volcano, yet no eruption actually occurred, with this sequence of events being surprisingly common there. And for this week's main story. In Russia, the Shiveluch volcano produced a powerful subplaneting eruption on April 11th, representing the planet's largest explosive volcanic eruption to occur in approximately 15 months, which destroyed the majority of a large lava dome that had grown at the volcano since 1964 and formed a 1,000-meter-wide crater in its place. This eruption consisted of a powerful explosion which was followed by long-reaching pyroclastic flows that traveled up to 19 kilometers or 11.8 miles distant, scorching approximately 110 square kilometers of terrain. As the more than 6-hour-long sustained eruption column occurred, ash was ejected to a height of 54,000 feet or 16.5 kilometers. Much of this ash drifted to the west, accumulating in areas such as the town of Klyuchi, where it was measured at 6 inches or 15 centimeters thick. This VEI-4 explosive eruption likely ejected around 0.2 cubic kilometers of tephra, and its ash plume caused some problems for those who lived in parts of the United States and Canada. This eventually caused around 7 dozen flight cancellations in Alaska, in addition to some other flight cancellations in the Northwest Territories, British Columbia, Alberta, and Washington. A viewer of mine even reported that some trace particles of ash fell in their car in eastern Washington. Meanwhile, in Arizona, I noticed that around the same time a section of the sulfur dioxide plume was overhead, solar panel-related power production on my roof during clear skies decreased by 4%. At the Aniakchak volcano in Alaska, which produced two powerful VEI-6 explosive eruptions in 6300 BCE and 1541 BCE, it was finally confirmed that a magmatic intrusion is ongoing at a depth of around 2 to 2.5 miles below sea level. This magmatic intrusion may have begun all the way back in October of 2022, and has since then resulted in an increasing number of presumably volcano tectonic earthquakes. More notably, a section of ground within the caldera that is centered above an unnamed vent was uplifted by about 4 inches a week between February and March of 2023. This rate has since decreased to 3 centimeters a week between March 23rd and April 4th of 2023. The presence of this intrusion means it is somewhat likely that a volcanic eruption will occur at this complex sometime in the next 5 years, although this is not a certainty. Such an eruption could even reach the size of a VEI-4, although a VEI-3, in my opinion, appears more likely to occur if an eruption does end up occurring. In Alaska, an information statement was put out regarding the Katmai volcano, which famously collapsed into a caldera due to the voluminous explosive eruption of Novarupta in 1912. This 1912 eruption created the so-called Valley of 10,000 Smokes, with up to 150 meters or 492 feet thick of ignimbrite and ash being deposited there during a VEI-6 explosive eruption, which is 24 times larger than the 1980 eruption of Mount St. Helens. Despite being slightly more than a century later, a surprisingly large amount of this material is still quite loose. Thus, when high winds occur, some of this material can become resuspended, creating a weak ash plume which can actually damage aircraft if they come too close, even though a volcano is not actively erupting when this occurs. Such an event occurred on April 9, 2023 due to sustained winds of between 25 and 30 miles per hour, with the hazard not occurring the following day. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on April 15th of 2023. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.